Hack McGee's open for business. Check out some cool shit. Postman Pat. Postman Pat Quest, Escape from Tarkov.
Guys, just a heads up that any task could change in the future, so this could be wrong like in a year's time. So just bear in mind that stuff can be subject to change. So just look at the date this video was published, and if I'm wrong in a next update or whatever, just let me know and I'll take the video down and I'll redo the appropriate task guide for that mission. So just bear that in mind. Thank you for watching. Okay, the next mission is called Postman Pat. On this mission, you need to recover a letter from one of Prepple's workers who died with the letter on his body. The letter is in the factory on a dead scav, and I'm just gonna do a run and show you where it is. Now, factory is a bit tough to get extracted because you gotta extract with the letter. So you gotta have a couple things to make it a bit easier. One, you need to have a very good spawn, and two, you could do with having the factory key so you can get extracted closer to where you find the letter instead of the standard extraction, where chances are you're going to get killed. Once you have the letter, you hand it over to the therapist and the task is complete. Okay, I've spawned in, and I've spawned an offline spawn, practically the best spawn to have when you're looking for this letter. So my advice, just let everyone run around for a bit, sort themselves out where they want to go, and take the underground. Keep following the tunnel, turn right, and turn left. You see this building with the green lights, the lockers, and the dead body? If you look on his chest, you should see a letter. Grab it. To get the fuck out and just follow your route back. These tunnels are really good, give you a lot of cover. That's the wrong way. Easy to get lost in it. And if you have the factory key, then take the extraction closer to the offline spawn. And it's simple as that. I mean, you're going to be lucky, and sometimes you're going to be unlucky. It depends where you spawn and.
I backed out. Looks like I had a little bit of an error previously. So my headset isn't on and just want to go back and make sure I put it on. And sure enough, the game's done this to me a couple times where there's an error and I've done something and then it reverses it and undoes what I did. And then I go in without a key or whatever that I might have had before. Now, here's the funny part. It looks like my. Oh, there it is. Okay, I was gonna say it looks like my equipment was missing, but it's right there. So I want my headset on instead of the side ear protection. I got my key that I put in there and everything's good. All right, so now we'll try this again. Factory battery, there we go. Should have brought some grenades too. Should always, if you're doing a PMC run, you should always bring grenades if you can afford it. That was bullshit. It spawned me right in front of 50 people or some crap like that. Like, that's such a bad spawn. I can't believe they just spawned me in with all those people like that. Usually they spawn you a little bit better of an area. Bullshit. Here's hoping I don't get spawned in front of fucking 10 people again. Never seen that before.
Я толкнул все и в продуктовый.
Нормально, нормально, живем, пацаны.
Thank you.
No, that's bullshit. That's bullshit. Didn't get out in time. There's fucking scavs everywhere. There's a battle every time. Crazy. Should be compatible, it's crazy. Ten round clips, fuck that. a different. Oh, never mind.
Keep following the tunnel. Turn right. Turn left. You see this building with the green lines?
So get out. This is intense.
А вот тут друган мой бывал.
Батон в будку закидывай.
Вот ты шалава!
Блядь, берца щеми! Ах ты ебагло! What the?
No pee.
Extraction time! Then. $5,000, that's it for that? What a joke. Ugh, what a joke. Start with the backpack. Routine. Golden Swag Quest, Escape from Tarkov.
Hey guys, Wolverine here on Tarkov, and on this episode I am here covering the quest called Golden Swag from Skier. So, pretty straightforward quest, guys. You need the 303 key. That's where the golden light is located on the desk. I'll show you where it is. So, make sure you have a 303 key for the dorms on customs. 303 key is pretty common. You should be able to find it in filing cabinets pretty easy. So once you have the 303 key, go to the dorms. So my best advice is to you can spawn in two different locations on customs, custom side or boiler tank side. I'd recommend boiler tank side because there you go, place the gold lighter is on the custom side where you used to spawn a few patches ago by the red warehouse customs building. So it's in the three-story dorm.
Healthcare privacy too.
Hey guys, and welcome to the Therapist 12 Task Healthcare Privacy Part 2. For this task, you need to gather information on the brain and the table room research, which means you need to go to the resort and go into the west side and get into room 306. That door is locked, so first of all, you need to get the west room 306 key from factory. So when you're inside factory, what you need to do is head into the middle of factory where the office building is. What you need to do is head into the locker room. Along the very back wall, there is a line of lockers. As you can see here, this is where the key spawns on the shelf. Now that you got the 306 key, you need to head over to Shoreline.
Shaking up the teller.
Hey guys, Wolverine here on Tarkov, and on this episode I am going to be covering the quest called Shaking Up Teller. Good old Proper has given us a quest and wants us to find a bank case. To get this, you need the 203 key. If you haven't got that, basically you need a 203 key. So the bank case is in room 203, but to access to that, if you haven't got a 203 key, you need a 214 key to open the door to get the 203 key. So I'm just going to show you where to get them from. You need a 214 key, which is from filing cabinets. Once you've done that, come to the three-story doors and go onto the second floor. So we're doing the main entrance, up the stairs, turn left, all the way down the corridor. The 203 key is in room 214. You can find 203 and 214 in the planning cabinets. There's a guaranteed 203 key in this room. Another method to get in, if you get a little bit lost, just follow the wall and then look at these steps. Come up the steps, open the door, turn right, the door's here for you. Once you open the 214 room, the handy room, has followed a wall, and then look at these steps. Come up the steps, open the door, turn right, the door's here for you. The 203 key is in room 214. You can find 203 and 214 in the filing cabinets, but there's a guaranteed 203 key in this room. Another method to get in, if you get a little bit lost, just follow the wall and then look at these steps. Come up the steps, open the door, turn right. So, I'm just going to show you where to get them from. You need a 214 key, which is from filing cabinets. Once you've done that, come to the three-story dorms and go onto the second floor. So we're doing the main entrance, up the stairs, turn left, all the way down the corridor. 203 key is in room 214. You can find 203 and 214 in the planning cabinets, but there's a guaranteed 203 key in this room. Another method to get in if you get a little bit lost, just follow the wall and then look at these steps. Come up the steps, open the door, the red cup just left. Take and examine. As you can see, I am struggling a little bit here. I just heard movement, so I was just waiting to see if that door would open. Just showing you how that it's not going to be you guys if you're struggling to pick the key up. There we go. Okay, once you have the 203 key, you are able to go to room 203. So follow the same corridor, back the way you came, all the way down the corridor until you see a bed and a chair. Jump over, it's going to be a bit tricky, so just left and right, crouch, whatever. Look to your left, it's the room with a 20 with no 3, and as you can see, the 3 is on the floor. This is the room 203. Once you unlock the door, open it, and look to your right underneath the bed. The bank case is there. Now you need to grab that and then.
We're gonna go to customs and try to bang out this quest. Oh, you need some water first. Some energy. Should have some juice or something in here somewhere. Where is it? Going to the dorms, man. incredible, man. Incredible.
Bunny.
Ooh, scared me, dude.
What?
Timer? That was fucking dangerous, dude. All right. Only 800 XP? That's bullshit. The mission I just pulled off there. We'll be right back.
Did you bring me coffee?
Ay, ay, ay. Let's go see if I can make my scav box yet. Scav box. It is shit. Alright. Okay. You gotta have the gift of gab for these streams. You gotta keep talking about the game, keep the audience involved and interacting with them. And I guess I'm too new to this game right now because I'm focused more on the task at hand and what I gotta try to do to accomplish the quest here. But this is a pretty big quest, gotta kill like 25 scabs. Got to do it all at once, but see if we can bang out a few, extract, bang out a few more, extract, just rinse and repeat. Got my map up over here to my left, that's why I keep looking to my left. All right, we're about ready to get in there. About ready to get in there. Let's go.
Fuck off!
don't think I have any clips of. That's the real problem here. gonna reload the game. Seems to be acting up. Connect to a different server or something. I'll be right back while this loads up. Got no armor, no helmet. This is probably gonna be a mistake, but whatever. Lost all my good armor and helmets today. All of them legit, except for maybe two of them. Loading's taking a while.
Ugh.
Stupid game. Mm-hmm. Yeah, what's up? Suck you. Fucking bullshit, man. Fucking no ammo left in that gun. God damn it. Fuck me, dude. Shouldn't have even switched to that gun. I should have fucking went out there and chased that douche down. Fuck was he not dying?